Hello and welcome back to 365 Days with MXM Tune, but with a twist. I'm Maya, a singer, songwriter, video maker, and Oakland native. I'm also a huge fan of history. I love untold stories, gross facts, hidden secrets, anything weird, dark, and funky from the past. This month, we have some very special episodes. Each week, one of my friends will be taking over the podcast to share their favorite deep cuts with you. This week's host is Ricky Montgomery, who you may recognize from songs like Mr. Loverman or Line Without a Hook. So Ricky, take it away.
It's 365 with
Ricky Montgomery.
New facts every day, so don't leave too soon. I'm gonna teach you stuff, no it won't be tough. Gonna go a year till you've had enough. It's 365.
Today in 2013, the Swedish furniture megastore IKEA stopped selling moose meat lasagna in stores worldwide. This change was prompted by a meat adulteration scandal in which it was realized that the moose meat lasagna contained about 1.4% pork. This is actually a serious problem considering that some people who practice religions like Judaism and Islam don't eat pork for spiritual reasons. Also, no one wants to eat contaminated food regardless of what's being served. But I'm still hung up on another aspect of this story. Moose meat lasagna? At IKEA? IKEA might be a furniture store, but it's also a weirdly fun place to spend an afternoon. Maybe we got this idea from the romantic comedy 500 Days of Summer, where the lead couple has a kitschy yet romantic date at the store, pretending as though they live in all the beautifully minimalist, fashionable furniture displays. And if you get hungry looking at all those sleek, stylish kitchens, you're in luck because most IKEAs have a cafeteria. The food is actually pretty good, though, which is weird. Keeping true to their Swedish roots, they serve their classic Swedish meatballs with lingonberry sauce. Some stores even sell soft-serve sundaes. It's like a theme park for people who get really excited about Tupperware and, like, clothing organizers. Anyway, the moose meat lasagna scandal. So, moose meat isn't uncommon in Sweden, though apparently putting it into lasagna is. This makes sense, since there are just more moose in that part of the world. And by the way, the plural of moose is moose, not meese. Apparently it tastes gamey, like deer, I guess? But moose meat lasagna had only been in stores for a month when IKEA had to pull the product permanently. There were about 17,000 servings of the dish that were recalled. It was part of a crisis across Europe. Meats were mislabeled and mispackaged at a major frozen food plant, causing a continent-wide pandemonium. A few months before this particular incident, in February 2013, IKEA had to pull their signature meatballs from stores as well. In the Czech Republic, food inspectors found the meatballs to be contaminated with horse meat. But meatballs from that same batch had already been sent to several other countries like France, England, Italy, Portugal, Spain, and more. Other retailers like Burger King and Walmart had similar issues with horse meat in Europe. By now, you're probably wondering how this whole horse meat scandal happened in the first place, or perhaps why this is even such a big deal in the first place. If you can eat a moose, you can probably eat a horse, right? Sure, but the reason why horse meat isn't very common in our diet is that horses are often treated with an anti-inflammatory drug called BOOT, which is banned from the human food chain. In some cases, ingesting it can cause life-threatening illnesses. So, after this whole scandal, it became legally mandated that horse carcasses had to be tested for BOOT before being put into production. The strange thing about the horse meat scandal is that most beef burgers, for example, aren't even 100% beef. According to the Food Standards Agency of the United Kingdom, a standard beef burger can be classified as such if it contains at least 62% beef. It's not fun thinking about what the other 38% might hold. Okay, it's not as horrific as it sounds. It's mostly seasonings, preservatives, and other chemicals that are often included in frozen food. But it's even less fun to imagine that there might be life-threatening anti-inflammatory drugs for horses in there. So that's what caused this whole uproar. Anyway, I guess we won't be eating any moose meat lasagna next time we need to buy a new bookshelf. For today's music fact, we have a very special guest. Leve is here to talk about the release of her single, Street by Street.
Hi, this is Leve, and today is a very special day, April 6th, because a year ago, I released my first single, Street by Street. It was around the time that everyone was in lockdown because of COVID, and it truly gave me something to be really excited about during such a strange, strange time. I was at home with my parents, and I remember being so touched by all the good messages that I was receiving from listeners all over the world. It was from that day that I knew that this was what I wanted to do for the rest of my life.
Thanks for going back in time with me, and remember to subscribe wherever you listen to podcasts. Come back tomorrow for more stories from the past.
It's 365 with
Ricky Montgomery.
New facts every day, so don't leave too soon. I'm gonna teach you stuff, no, it won't be tough. Gonna go a year till you've had enough. It's